Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I am going to discuss about Kafka offset management. This topic was also requested by one of my subscribers. So in this video I'll try to explain what is Kafka offset management. We'll see a small theoretical part on that and later we'll move further and understand how to handle this programmatically in Spark and Scala. So for a brief introduction, I'll take you to Kafka official documentation. Here if you see the official explanation says like, if there is a producer which is producing the messages sequentially, as you can see in this diagram, the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the messages being written by a producer. And each of these messages is supposed to be consumed by a consumer code. As these messages come in as a stream, so there is a specific value assigned with each message that is being written by a producer. That specific value to a message is called an offset. Consumer reads the required message based upon the offset. Suppose a consumer needs the latest message, he can point to the latest offset and then fetch the corresponding message. This sounds like a simple concept, but understanding the offset is very important and crucial if you have to work on the streaming data. Just taking a small example, you can understand like if suppose producer and consumers are running on two different machines, and suppose in any case the consumer or the producer goes down. So how do you ensure that none of the data in the stream gets lost and the data integrity is maintained? So that is why this offset understanding is very important. You can achieve many things if you understand these offset concepts and what all you can achieve with this if you are given different use case scenarios. So I'll explain you how you can get started with this concept and achieve this programmatically in your Spark application using Scala. So let me go to my Cloudera VM. This is a simple Spark streaming code that I have built in one of my previous videos. If you have not seen that video, I'll give that link in the description as well as the I button. Please go watch this video. In that, I have made this code from the scratch. Also, if you want, please build the same code along with that video explanation. And if you want to do that later, let me tell you what this simple program does. This is basically a consumer code. When we start a producer and start giving input messages, it does a word count on the streaming input. Let me show you a quick demo. This program will listen to topic Kafka OS. So let me initiate a producer that will write to this Kafka OS topic. So our Kafka producer is started. Let me start class. I have mentioned 10 seconds, so it will listen to that producer every 10 seconds. Now this is listening every 10 seconds to that producer. I'll start entering messages. If you can see, it is counting whatever messages I am giving it. So this is the basic program. So just to give you a picture, these are the messages that we are giving as an input to a producer from our command line. So ideally these messages have the offset, but we are not able to see here. If you can see, we can just see the message because I have already given a print statement here, line.print, that is why I am able to see. But anyways, we are not able to see the offset that is assigned to this message. So how we can achieve that programmatically? We are going to see what code we can introduce so that along with this, we can also get the offset that each and every message is being assigned to. We'll perform a for each functions on our messages RDD. Messages dot for each. And here we can map and take the offset ranges from this RDD. We'll define a new variable, offset ranges. RDD as instance of as offset ranges dot offset ranges. Now we can iterate on this for each partition. We'll define an iterator and define an object for offset range. Offset range will be offset ranges object. There will be task context that you will require here. If you have not already imported, it will prompt you to do that. Partition ID. Now this offset object is able to give you the details, something like topics, partitions, from and to offsets and all. I'll show you how you can take that. For now I'll just print it. So I'll give whatever the values we require on whatever topic we are getting the values. That also we can take or use wherever we want. O dot topic. Same way, this can provide us the from and to offsets. From offset, and if you want to use to offset, you have to use until offset. So we have given print statement. Let's hit that again and see if we are able to get these values, from and to offsets. See, we are getting the topic and from and to offsets. If you see why this two is coming, because we already entered two messages in my previous demo, if you remember. So let's see once again. This, see, two messages I have already entered, so that is why our from and until offsets both are two, because the first offset was for this message and second offset was from this message. And now from offset, what it is expecting, it is expecting 2, and it's displaying value until 2. So let's see. I will enter 2 to 3 messages now. Message 1, message 2, message 3. Now let's see what we get. If you see here, we are getting from offset as 2, because obviously when this program was started, it was expecting offset 2, and we have already entered 3 messages. So our until offset will become 5. So it is reading from 2 to 5. So this way, with this piece of code, we are able to see what messages are related to which offsets. So let's see few things which we can do on the message stream with the help of offsets. If you see, till now we have 5 messages in this producer topic. So to make you understand properly, let me take these messages. And if you see, we have the offsets 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. As we already saw here, we have from 2 to 5. Now let's see what happens if I start this consumer once again. Please notice carefully, it is pointing to 5, the latest offset, but it is not listing the previous messages. So what if we want these messages also, which we have already written to this producer topic? For this kind of requirement, there is another property that you can define for consumer config. The value is auto offset reset config. And for this, you can define the property earliest. Also, when you're defining this, just make sure you have already disabled the auto commit config. So we'll define consumer config enable auto commit to false. So you saw what output we got when we ran this program again. Now let's save it and try to run this again. If you see, we have already requested the earliest message from the topic, and also we have defined auto commit config to false. But what is happening? It is still not giving us the previous messages. I'll tell you the reason. By default, this auto commit config was true. That is why we have set it to false. So till now, whatever messages were written, the commit was done to the latest message. Here the message offset was committed. But watch carefully what will happen now. It is listening from offset 5. Now I'll try to enter more messages. Message 4, message 5, message 6. So as usual, our program will work similar way. 5 to 6, message 4 we have got. I suppose message 5 and 6 also we have got. That is message 6 to 8. But if you remember, we have now set it to false. So no matter, we are getting new messages, but that consumer won't save that value as committed. I'll stop this program and I'll run the same again. Now if you see, we are getting messages starting from message 4. See, 5 to 8. 8 is now whatever it is expecting, but we are not given any message. So there is no message, and initial and final is same. But we are getting messages from message 4, 5, 6. Because from here, when we entered message 5, 6 and 7, so on, here it was not committed, because we have set that property. So currently our last commit is still on 4. So no matter, in such cases, even if the consumer goes down, see, suppose I am killing this, this represents a consumer going down. But again, if I am going to run this, it will read from the last committed offset. So last committed offset was 4. After that, message 5, 6, 7. If you see, our code is again giving us message 4, 5, 6, sorry. After 3, we have entered message 4, 5 and 6. But the offset is not committed. Now just for the demo, if we set this to true, enable auto commit, if we set it to true and we run our program again, you can see we are still getting 4, 5, 6 messages. But while running this program, this might have set this message 6 offset as committed. So I am hoping this is committed now. So now if I am going to run it again, it will search the earliest message from the latest committed offset. So it will search the earliest message after this message 6 offset. If you can see here, we are not getting the previous messages, and it is expecting the message to offset 8. As far as the storage of this offset is concerned, you can store this offset in different ways. Like you can store it in Zookeeper, you can store it in Kafka itself, you can store it in some external database like HBase, and later you can handle your messages based upon different partitions and topics by using those offset values. I'll try to bring up more use case scenarios for Kafka Spark Streaming offset management. I believe after this video you will be having some idea on how to implement offset management programmatically. So if you found this video helpful, please hit that subscribe button if you have not already done. And also hit that like button and share this video among your friends if anyone is aspiring for big data interviews. Thank you guys, see you later.